question I want to ask you. Do you miss San and James?
It's a really tough question. A band is like a family, you know. And, you know, when the band first starts out, any band, it's like everybody loves everybody else. And everybody is supportive of everybody else. It's like, oh, let's do your song. Okay, let's do your song. Well, let's, you know. And it's real like this love fest and mutual support system. And all of a sudden, it reaches a certain point after a number of years where certain resentments build where someone is doing, well, how come we're doing all of your songs and only one of my songs? And in all of these little, and it's every band has the same story in a certain way. And Big Brother reached, you know, that several times in its evolution. And I think in the 90s, it kind of got to a point with James where he had this gigantic resentment of everybody. First it was me, then it switched from me to Sam, and eventually it was like everybody. And we just couldn't work together with him. And I loved the guy. But at the same time, I hated him because he just made me feel terrible every time I was around him, and I couldn't work with him anymore. After he died, which was around 2010, you know, you start, you only remember the good stuff. You remember all the laughs and the wonderful times in the early days when it was like a love fest. And it's the same thing with Sam. I just, you know, the last probably 7 years that we worked together, we were at loggerheads all the time. It was like a battle of the egos. He wanted to run the show, he wanted to be the musical director, and I wanted to have a certain input into things, and he didn't, you know, he really didn't want that. He really wanted to be like the leader. And we had a lot of build-up resentments, yet the funny thing about it was that he was dying, he was in the hospital, and he was dying, and his wife said, you know, well, will you go and see him? And I said, you sure Sam wants to see me? You really sure? And she said, no, he really does, you know. And so I went, you know, and he was laying there, you know, really dying, you know. When someone's dying, you know they don't have much time. And it was, you know, it was very heart-wrenching because sort of all the stuff that is, you know, all that other bullshit kind of is minor, becomes very insignificant. So that's kind of the only way I can answer those questions. I miss those guys when I kind of, you know, try to think of the good stuff. When you think of the good stuff and you think of what they contributed, of how in some way they were so important to creating the whole thing of what the band was and its history. At the same time, do I miss the individual moments when I hated this guy's guts and when he was trying to humiliate me or when he was putting me down or telling me, you know, this or, and I was telling, you know, I try not to focus on that.
You know? Well, it's just like family.
Exactly, exactly. So, you know, it's a complicated question. You can't answer just yes or no. In the long run, I think the good side of people, you try to remember that more than the other. And you try to give more weight to that and what the person's contribution to the music.
I'm not afraid to die. This is a song Janice brought to the band. Yeah, we did it a little different, but the words are pretty meaningful.
All right, I'm going to do a little medley for you.
Thank you.
My question is, how do you feel about the latest version of Big Brother and the Hidden Brother?
Yeah, we had a fantastic version. In October, we went to the Netherlands, we went to Holland. And there's a gal who played with us over the years. She plays violin and keyboards and sings. Her name is Kate Thompson, Kate Russo.
I've seen her play on YouTube.
Yeah, and she started actually playing with us in the 90s in New York, where we were going to, started going to New York, and in the late 90s, there was a club called Manny's Car Wash that we played a lot. And Kate, who was probably in her early 20s then, would come down and sit in. And, you know, she was great then. And over the years, she, at some point, she toured with us, and she went to Mexico with us, and then she went on another tour. But mainly, she's not been in the band. Mainly, we've had two guitars, rather than guitar and violin. And we got this thing going in Holland. Actually, what it started actually, when Sam died, we had a memorial show for Sam at the Great American Music Hall, and Kate came out from Boston, where she lives. She's got four kids now. She got married, she's got four kids. She does a Janis cover band, and she does a lot of other bands. And she came out for the memorial, and she was just so, she just knocked my socks off so much. I said, we gotta get Kate in the band somehow. And so this Holland thing came up, and I asked her to be in the band rather than the guitar player who we'd been playing with locally, who was a great guitar player named Tommy Adetto. And, and Tommy's a phenomenal player. And Tommy and Tom Finch, the two of them are great players. And we had this two guitar thing. But I just thought Kate, in some way, being a woman and playing violin and being able to also play keyboards and also great singer, she would really like add a lot. Plus, she's just exciting on stage. Then we didn't know who the singer was going to be for this tour, and I asked like about five of our regular great singers who have been with us over the years if they could do it. None of them could do it at the time. And Peter said, well, there was a gal who went to Italy with us about 2 years before on a gig that I didn't go on because it was a one-off. It was like a, $25,000 one show, and I just figured I cannot do that. I can't fly to like Rome and fly back the next day. It's too much wear and tear. So I hired another guy who's played with the band, a very good drummer, to do it, and I paid him very well to basically sub it. So I didn't do that gig. So people said, you know, the singer who did that gig was a gal in Tampa, Florida. Her name is Eileen Humphreys, and she was really good. And I say, okay, Peter, you know, I'm going to ask her. So Eileen says, yeah, I'd love to do it, you know. So I'd never heard her. Anyway, we got to Holland, and it was just fucking great. It was just like the chemistry. It was like the best, it was the best lineup we've probably had, I don't know, since, you know, maybe in the, somewhere in the last 15 years, in my estimation. Even though we don't have Sam, the singer was just great, just a fantastic singer, and with Kate, like two women, and myself and Peter, and Tom Finch, great guitar player, the whole chemistry of the thing was just phenomenal. It was just, we had this really great band. So I was like very excited about that. We made this video, we made a, an hour 40 minute video, which we made a 3 minute version of, which is on YouTube.
I think I saw that.
You saw it.
Really good.
Yeah, it's really good, and everybody in it is great. And I'm trying to sort of promote that. When we play locally, I can't do that. We can't afford to bring someone from Boston and someone from Tampa. So we have two, you know, local people who do it. And usually the local people is Darby Gould. And Darby's a wonderful singer. She sang with the Jefferson Starship. And she's just an all-around good singer. I would not put her in the top five Big Brother singers of last week, but I think she's good, and I think she can, you know, she gets the job done.
She carries it.
She carries it. She can carry it. And then with guitar players, sometimes it's Tommy, but Tommy lately, Tommy's got his own thing now going. And so this next gig we're doing, we're going to be using a guitar player who we've used before. He's done three shows with us now. He's a wonderful guitar player and a wonderful guy to work with. His name is David Aguilar.
Yeah, I've seen him play.
And David Aguilar is a wonderful player and just a great person, just a really easy person to work with who really compliments. You know, he's not like a star, but we have Tom Finch, and
he's
Tom
like a,
Finch is like
a journeyman. Yeah,
he's a journeyman. He's a great journeyman player, and he can, I mean, he can solo. He's a good, great rhythm player. Just, you know, he really fills out the sound of the band. So we have a very good local band, but I'm very excited. I'm trying to kind of promote the idea of getting this band that we had in Holland and get it out there. I know they want us to come back to Holland in September. They've already sort of booked some things for this same lineup to come back to Holland in September, so we'll see. But meanwhile, I'm just gonna start to send out this video. We just got it edited down actually a couple of weeks ago to the 3-minute thing. And I'm gonna be sending that out to different booking agents and our own booking agent who is in the Bay Area, Steve DeKaiser.
Yeah.
He's sending it out. So we're trying to kind of generate more work, but the problem with the video, of course, is that band that's on that video can't do California gigs unless it pays more than $5,000, because it's going to cost like a couple of $1,000 in round trip tickets to bring people out from Boston and Florida. So you know, we'll see what happens. But that's the most exciting thing I think that's happened in the last 2 years since Sam's passing. We've had mostly Darby and Tommy and Tom and Tommy and different, you know, mostly that's been the lineup, that lineup with Tommy Abetto and Tom Finch and Darby Brewer. But this other lineup that we took to Holland was like a jump in levels from that. And it was chemistry. It was mostly just chemistry. It was just this excitement and interaction on stage between the people, and plus the fact that each one of these people, I mean, not, I forget Peter and I, we're just the sort of the rock that holds it together. But Tom Finch, Kate Russo, and Eileen Humphries, they're all phenomenal players, you know? And they all, in their own right, could, you know, hold the stage. That's what I'm excited about.
I'm gonna wrap it up because it's gonna start raining on us.
I know.
So you've toured Europe the past couple of months. So what's the next phase for this year, 2017?
Don't know. We really don't know. We've got this thing coming up. We've got nothing, as far as I know, on the horizon after January 13th. There's nothing booked, and it's scary. It's the first time that we've faced this kind of situation in a long time. There's always been, you know, a couple of things a month, 2 months in advance.
And you always have the train going.
Yeah, the train's always going. And right now, I'm sure there's going to be something, but, you know, it's a hard time right now because it's winter time. And traditionally, December, January is slow time. Things start to pick up in February, so we'll see what happens.
Well, Dave, thank you for taking the time to talk to me at Pow Magazine.
Thank you.
I appreciate it very, very much for sharing your life story.
No problem. That's great. Always fun.
All right, here's a song that it talks about, I guess, the time when you need somebody to, you know, be there for you. You need help and you need some help too, so this is what you do.
When you find
song that we get requests for all the time. This is not one of our older tunes. This is a Kris Kristofferson tune. Yeah. And many people have done this, including, what's this guy's name?
Hey.
Bob Weir. I can't remember.
That other guy.
Rapper Jack Elliott.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Good enough.
I love how some companies take songs and turn them into names of their companies. One was a place that served Italian pizza down in
Santa Cruz,
called Pizza of My Heart. We're gonna do that song right now.
Pizza. Good place.
Also, as a band, we don't usually make political statements or anything like that, but I just want to say, what the fuck?
Oh, and also, we're sending our love out to Dave and Mark from Tower of Power. Everyone, put them in your thoughts. You can go online and donate to their medical funds, because thank goodness they need it.
Good thoughts after that.
Woo-wee! Don't do that. Don't try to beat a train. Because another one might be coming the other way.
Thank you.
much. We hope to be here again.
Oh,
in Mercedes-Benz. My friends all drive Porsches. I must make amends. Work hard all my lifetime. No help from my friends. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes-Benz? Oh Lord, won't you buy me a color TV? No help from my friends. So, oh!